الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد محمد بن عبد الله عليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Finally, my dear brothers, the month of Ramadan, as we began, is a month of inspiration. It's a month of a call. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yad'una ila al-khayr. He invites us to that which is good. And He wants us to come towards that which is righteous. And He seeks for us to draw nearer and nearer to the path of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in this month of Ramadan, as much as we seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must be also willing to sacrifice certain things. And it's important for us, just like we make the invitation to al-khayr, also we do not ever disregard or forget the words of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as they relate to the prohibitions and the disliked activities in the month of Ramadan. And you do find it strange that a person can be in a state of siyam from food and drink, and at the same time their ears are full of music, and their eyes are full of certain images of vulgarity, and that their tongues cannot hold back from sinful words and gossip. And therefore the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that the one who cannot restrain themselves, you can't hold back your tongue, you can't hold your eyes and your ears from that which is vulgar, فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةً أَنْ يَدْعَ طُعَامَهُ وَشَرَابًا. That person is also not in need. Allah is not in need of them to leave off their food and their drink. This, of course, does not mean that your reward of fasting is zero or that you have gotten nothing from your fasting. No. It is a way of the Prophet ﷺ in the balagha and modes of eloquence that the Arab know to inspire us to do good and to seek for us to do that which is best. And it's a part of our aqidah that a person who fasts to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from food and drink, yu'jar. He is given a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَهُ أَجْرٌ. That ajr is in compensation of what Allah knows. And Allah tells us subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَصَّوْمُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. Fasting is assessed only by me, and only I will reward for it. How much reward is with Allah? Is there reward? Yes. I wish to remind my brothers and sisters of a wonderful hadith of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he tells us in this hadith as a reminder to our duties that the month of Ramadan is not just introspective. It's not just about you. It's not just about you and Allah. It's not about you saying, I'm going to go to pray, you stay with the kids, to those of you who have wives. No. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam builds for us a real natural life, a way of living that fits all conditions and ways and modes of habitation and life. I want you to consider the words of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the one who gives food to someone who is fasting, كَانَ لَهُ مِثْلُ أَجْرِ الصَّائِمِ غَيْرَ أَنَّ أَجْرَ الصَّائِمِ لَا يَنْقُصُ شَيْئًا. The one who feeds the fasting person receives their reward, while the one fasting does not lose any reward. In that is a call from the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to look to others in our fast, to see who's in need, who needs food. I know you're going to say, oh, there's food everywhere. This is Australia, Brother Yahya. No. You and I know that there are students who come from other countries. And alhamdulillah, at Curtin, we always have an open venue for people to share in the iftar. But you're a family man. You have a wife, alhamdulillah, and children. You're always inviting friends. Take a day or two or three or more. وَصْحَبْ مَعَكْ. Take with you a couple of brothers who want a good meal, a home-cooked meal, where they're in the comfort of a home, international students. Open a door of happiness to someone. One of our brothers who left the university, he's back in Brunei. He sent me an email and I used to bring him to my place for iftar. No one knows this. He's gone now, so it's okay. I used to say, Brother Yahya, every Ramadan, wallahi, I would look forward to the day I come, even if it was only once or twice in the month, because I know I would have something different, and I, you know, we'd be in your home, and you know, it's different than sitting outside and just eating in a restaurant. Don't think that sadaqah is only for the poor. لا والله، إن month of رمضان إفطار الطعام giving the إفطار is a moment of joy and celebration that you share with others. Open opportunities of acquaintance with other people from different cultures, from different nationalities, from different places, that you come together and join in the spirit of Ramadan. Think, Ya Abdullah, that at this moment, in this month, for 30 days, that there is more than one out of every four people walking the earth who doesn't eat and drink when the sun is up. Ummah. It's an ummah. Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Lak al-fakhr. Have honor and pride in that. Don't look at yourself as a minority here today. But look at the brothers who are all over the world. From as far north as Azerbaijan to as far south as South Africa. To all the way in the east in China, to all the way in the frigid north of Canada. My cousin, he rings me up from a city called Saskatoon. Saskatoon is beyond, just near the Arctic Circle. It's summer, so it's not cold. And he says, Ya Sheikh Yahya, we are fasting 19 hours and 52 minutes. Lillahi ta'ala. What if I can't do it? He's a medical doctor. I told him, you begin the day fasting. If you feel sick, break it. Because you are now under those who are not well. Begin the day fasting. If you feel unwell, break it. And count the day and a time you can do it another time. Sweden, same thing. Norway, same thing. Fasting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that has reached every city on earth. Who have left their food and drink because يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Perhaps you will attain piety. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us taqwa of heart and taqwa on our tongue and taqwa in our eyes and ears and dealings. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with the izz of al-Islam and to help our brothers and sisters who are suffering in Syria. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring His nasr upon them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us help them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use us and use our wealth and our dua for them. And we make dua for those who cannot defend themselves, that Allah defends them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month of Ramadan to look down upon them with His mercy and His rahmah, and to fulfill their needs and the needs of all who are in a similar situation. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect our international students who are studying with us here at Curtin, and to return them to their homes safely with an earned degree and an earned reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to soften our hearts to the Qur'an and to fill us with love for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdibina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم تقبل شهر رمضان منا. اللهم تقبل لنا فيه صلاتنا وصيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا. اللهم تقبل شهر رمضان منا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأقم الصلاة.